Supporting men's health for Movember, this week on The Wire. ANZ tips price boom, Aussie vacancies ultra low, and RBA predicts rapid recovery. G'day guys, my name is Tim Guest, and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate, where you can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment, and more. Now please like, comment, and share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. So our top story for this week, ANZ tips price boom. So the continued rise of housing markets driven by owner-occupiers has prompted ANZ to upgrade its outlook for residential property. It is now tipping strong price rises over the next year, confirming similarly positive forecasts by Westpac and Commonwealth Bank. The bank's senior economists, Felicity Emmett and Adelaide Timbrell, are predicting a strong 2021 for Australian housing, building on the price uplift experienced by most capital cities and regional markets this year. We now expect house prices at the national level to rise over the balance of this year, they say. Next year, we expect price gains averaging 9% across the capital cities. Now, ANZ admits that its earlier forecast of a 10% drop in house prices was incorrect. It's now predicting housing prices in Perth are likely to jump 12%, Brisbane 9.5%, Hobart 9.4%. Now, Sydney prices are expected to rise 8.8%, but Melbourne prices will lag a little with only a 7.8% predicted growth there. They said the strength is largely being driven by owner-occupiers with low interest rates appealing to buyers in secure employment. Guys, now for our next story. Aussie vacancies, ultra low. So vacancy rates remain below 1% in most major cities and regional centres across Australia, placing upward pressure on residential rentals. The latest data from SQM Research shows that vacancies were between 0.6% and 0.9% in October in five of the eight capital cities, and that's Perth, Adelaide, Canberra, Hobart and Darwin. Now, Brisbane was a little higher at 2%. Now, the exceptions to the low vacancy trend are Melbourne and Sydney. So Melbourne rose from 3.8% in September to 4.4% in October, reflecting the exodus of residents to regional areas to escape the city's restrictions. Now, Sydney's vacancies rose from 3.5% to 3.6%. Now, in regional Australia, most significant cities and towns have vacancy rates well below 2%, with many under 1%. Now, SQM says house rents rose on average 2.1% in the capital cities in the past month, headed by a 4.2% monthly rise in Darwin, as well as significant increases in Perth. In fact, SQM report 10% growth in Perth over the last 12 months. There's also been growth in Adelaide and Canberra. In annual terms, house rents have increased 5.1%, led by Perth and Darwin, which have both increased 9.2%. Now, for our final story of the week, RBA predicts rapid recovery. So Reserve Bank Governor Philip Lowe says the Australian economy is poised for a rapid rebound from the COVID recession. And that's if the nation can keep the virus under control, giving the pent-up savings and massive financial stimulus washing through the system. Lowe has urged Australian businesses to be brave and seize the opportunities of the digital transformation of the Australian economy in the wake of the pandemic period. Now, speaking at a Committee for the Economic Development of Australia event this week, Lowe delivered an upbeat assessment of the economy, saying Australia was on the road to recovery with the potential to bounce back quickly should the health situation continue to improve. Now, warned loans, there is still considerable uncertainty about the outlook, but he says there is resilience built into the system. It's been remarkable that in 6 months, there's two or three vaccines that are in advanced stages of development, Lowe says. I'm encouraged by that. It's also plausible that a vaccine will be widely available as we start to get back to normal sometime over the next couple of years. He also notes that despite the downturn, household balance sheets are in good shape, and this is being aided by a lot of stimulus in the system. Well, guys, they're the top stories for the week. Now, please don't forget to like, comment, and share this video, and follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. Finally, guys, have a great week, and remember, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference. That's action. Thanks a lot. Bye for now.